Hi, welcome to my third floor, Aldine Avenue, Chicago, Illinois. I've always lived in third floor apartments ever since I moved here to Chicago many years ago. And recently I saw a story about a place called Nitwit Ridge in California. It was the homemade house of an eccentric, cantankerous old man who was living there on his own terms, much to the chagrin of the developing upscale neighborhood around him. And it was a very stimulating story, but I reached a point where I didn't want to hear too much about the actual details. Just want to let that whole idea germinate in my head and see what song would come out of it. So here's my story of life on Nitwit Ridge. Gonna live my life on Nitwit Ridge, beyond the pale, across the bridge, running on the red, flipping off the lids. That's how it is on Nitwit Ridge. Gonna build a house of rocks and bones and just enough glass so I won't throw stones. Gonna rule my world from an easy chair and a curly crown of old gray hair, because I'd rather be singing to old dogs and moons and big crazy ladies who sell fat balloons. I'd rather blow like a trumpet in some other key, shake their sticks at me. You can call me loony, you can call me nuts, you can call the cops, you can hate my guts. I'll just beat my drum, bang my pans and pots. Here on Nitwit Ridge, I call the shots, and I will chew on your ear if you'll swallow that dirt, and I'll live off the gravy stains on my shirt. I'm gonna speed all my teeth into an ocean of jokes and hit the water running with no lifeboats. When you've heard enough, you can get the hook, you can throw a fit, you can throw the book, you can pull my leg, you can yank the rug, but I'll just go on till they pull the plug. And when my tide is rolling out and my sun is going down, I'm gonna holler like the hurricanes that blow this world around, and I will drink my rhyme and reason from a rusted old cup and yell like the devil till the angels shut up. Gonna live my life on Nitwit Ridge, beyond the pale, across the bridge, running on the red, flipping off the Thanks. So, for a lot of us, we reach a certain age where we naively or arrogantly think that we've seen it all. Just like music and the arts and entertainment, there's always the next big thing. And that certainly applies to crazy. How did things get this crazy? The whole new normal is nothing but nuts. When did brains get so lazy and common sense get away from us? I thought I lost it long ago, but this one's new to me. 'Cause crazy ain't, crazy ain't, crazy ain't what it used to be. For every whacked out, cracked idea that smacked me in the face, I stood my ground to stare it down and put it in its place. Now every time I think it might be safe to turn my back, a brand new kind of crazy comes screaming down the track. Oh, how did things get this crazy? The whole new normal is nothing but nuts. When did brains get so lazy and common sense get away from us? I thought I lost it long ago, but this one's new to me. 'Cause crazy ain't, crazy ain't what it used to be. Stupid is as stupid does. What the hell was that? Landing in a sucker punch that knocked me cold and flat. What happened to the good old days when crazy ran amok? But at least you saw it coming and you had a chance to duck. But now that it's all gone bonkers, now that the belfry lost its bat, now that the wigs are flipping, hell's handbasket's here at last. Oh, hey, did I mention? Oh, say, can you see that crazy ain't, crazy ain't, crazy ain't what it used to be? But I'll just stay bewildered and befuddled and perplexed, flummoxed and kerfuffled to see what happens next. The comfort of confusion always helps me keep my wits, 'cause when this all makes sense to me, that's when I'll call it quits. Oh, how did things get this crazy? The whole new normal is nothing but nuts. When did dumb get so lazy and something worse get the best of us? I know I lost it long ago, but this one ain't on me. 'Cause crazy ain't, crazy ain't, crazy ain't what it used to be. So I spend a lot of time in New England. I've got a lot of family up there. And I was driving around with my brother in northern Massachusetts on up into New Hampshire. And I noticed in the residential sections, there were a lot of grottos to the Blessed Mother, these real nice half-shell alcoves with the statue right there. And then we got close to one, and then I noticed something. So I said to my brother, that's a bathtub. And he very nonchalantly said, oh, yeah, we've got bathtub Marys all over the place. And I thought, bathtub Mary, whoa, maybe that's some sort of cult or at least some statement on good, clean Christian living. But before anybody changed my mind on that, I said, no, write the song. So here's the bathtub Mary.
I've traveled all around the world to find the perfect prayer. From temples to cathedrals, searching everywhere. Till one day in New Hampshire's rolling hills I came upon a white cast iron grotto on my Uncle Andre's lawn. I always do as they will do in someone else's town, but this was just an old bathtub half buried in the ground, with a Blessed Mary statue staring straight at me. So I shouted Ave, Ave, and I got down on my knees. Bathtub Mary, wash me up,
take my soul and scrub it of my sins away. Now I pray the bathtub Mary every day. It ain't no cloak of Guadalupe, ain't no shrine of Lourdes, no miracle of Fatima, but one thing that's for sure, when she intercedes for us, the good Lord always hears. And I even scrub my fingernails and wash behind my ears. Bathtub Mary, wash me up, take my soul and scrub it up my sins away. I pray to Bathtub Mary every day. She may not cure the blind, the lame, or open heaven's gate, but if I comb my hair and shave, I just might get a date. And all the fresh, clean feeling that comes from faith and hope, with a lot of charity and a little bit of soap. Bathtub Mary, wash me up, take my soul and scrub it of my sins away. I pray to Bathtub Mary every day. So if you're ever in New England and you need to say a prayer, just pull into a driveway, you just might find one there. Cleanliness and godliness are virtues, that's a fact. Always do your laundry if you don't believe in that. Bathtub Mary, wash me up, take my soul and scrub it of my sins away. I pray to Bathtub Mary, I pray to Bathtub Mary, I pray to Bathtub Mary every day.
Amen. Here's a tragic tale of lost love in the state of Pennsylvania. It's a story of an unfortunate fellow who experienced a complete brain burnout from mixing the fires of love with his valiant attempt at knowing where he was going and what he was talking about as he traveled through the state of Pennsylvania. So this is for all my friends out there in Pennsylvania, friends and family. You just might hear your hometown mentioned, or your favorite town. From Shamokin to Shikshinimakanakwa to Tamaqua, Catawissa, Catasauqua, I've been searching for my love. Yes, from Wilmerding to Womelsdorf to Nescapec, I'll set a course and search for what's her name in Pennsylvania. From Machunk to Punxsutawney, Manny on to Manitani, I've been looking for the one who has me carrying this flame. All through Aliquippa, Allegheny, searching for my pretty baby. Now if I could just recall her name. What's her name? What's her name? What's her name in Pennsylvania? Now I'm following the force of nature, lost among the nomenclature. Where is what's her name in Pennsylvania? Oh, I fell in love with what's-her-name, and she ran off to Pennsylvania, leaving me insanely searching for her every day. Now I've got no time to dilly-dally, all alone with Rand McNally, searching everywhere and every way. What's her name? What's her name? What's her name in Pennsylvania? If I'm friendly with the population, careful with pronunciation, I'll find what's her name in Pennsylvania. In Wap Wallop, in a Wall and Popak, I must get my baby back, but Mahatonga, Monongahela, Altoona will do. So from Pocono to Nanticoke to Perkiomen, I'll be roaming Conowango, Conshohocken too. What's her name? What's her name? What's her name in Pennsylvania? As I'm lost in this monstrosity of merciless verbosity, I'll search for what's her name in Pennsylvania. As I'm lost in this monstrosity of merciless verbosity, I'll search for what's her name in Pennsylvania. Thanks. Watch out. So earlier I did a song about names of towns and locations in Pennsylvania, and everything was quite a mouthful. And I was recently back in Pennsylvania, and I was going by Mehoopany, Pennsylvania. And I realized I blew it. If any town name belonged in that song, it was Mahopani. What a great sound, and the possibilities of what it means and what goes on there. So in order to correct this sin of omission as a songwriter, I tried to fit it in there, but the song was already crowded and verbose. So Mahopani gets its own song, the whole thing. I've been here, there, everywhere. Autumn in New York was fair. Paris in the spring, blasé, Oklahoma. Okay. How are things in Glockamora? Couldn't care less, so I won't bore ya with the moonlight in Vermont or sun on Galway Bay. 'Cause somewhere north of Scranton, there's a town that's so enchanting, and though it might sound strange, I get turned on by the name. And baby, there is nothing else that I would rather do than make some whoopee in Mahopani, Pennsylvania with you. Well, I gave regards to old Broadway, but really didn't have much to say. Sang the blues on Basin Street, heard birds at Capistrano tweet. But I've got somewhere else to go, just northwest of the Poconos, with more than Georgia on my mind and wings upon my feet. 'Cause in the land of Quakers, there's a place for whoopee makers, and judging from the handle, it's a perfect place for scandal. So keep that name aflaming, 'cause tonight you're gonna be making whoopee in Mahopani, Pennsylvania with me. I've been up and down, and I'm so over the Black Hills and White Cliffs of Dover. The blue moon of Kentucky shines, but I've seen that a thousand times. I get no kicks on 66. Blueberry Hill has lost its buzz. I never miss the Mississippi anymore, because along the Susquehanna, I'm still the top banana. Apples, peaches, pumpkin pie, if you're ready, so am I. And baby, there is nothing else that I would rather do than make some whoopee in Mahopani, even though I shouldn't be. That whoopee just keeps putting me right back in Mahopani, Pennsylvania with you. Thanks. Here's a song that changed my life. It was the first John Prine song I ever heard, even before I even heard John Prine sing it. A friend of mine, Lex Romaine, in Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania, played this at a college coffee house. And then something struck me. I said, boy, this is different. So less than 2 years later, I was living in Chicago, hanging around their old town, trying to figure out how to do this stuff. And so thank you, Lex, and of course, thank you, John Prine. We're really gonna miss you.
Had an apartment in the city. Me and Retta like living there. It'd been years since the kids have grown a life of their own, left us alone. John and Lennon and an Omaha. Joe is somewhere on the road. We lost Davy in the Korean War. Still don't know what for. Doesn't that old trees just grow stronger. Old rivers grow wilder every day. No, people just grow lonesome, waiting for someone to say me and the rat, I went on talk much more. She sits and stares through the back door screen. And all the news just repeats itself like some forgotten dream that we've both seen. Someday I'll go and call a broody. We work together in the factory. What can I say if he asks what's new? Nothing, what's with you? Nothing much to do. Know that old trees just grow stronger. Old rivers grow wilder every day. Just grow lonesome, waiting for someone to say hello in there, hello. If you're walking down the street sometime, spot some hollow-reach eyes. Please just don't pass them by and stare as if you didn't care. Say hello in there.
John Prine. Thank you. I always like to dedicate this song to my first music teacher, Sister Joseph Therese, when I was sort of kind of attempting to learn the trumpet, and it didn't really take for several reasons. But you'd go up to the convent after school, go in a side door, and she had her music studio with this big old upright piano, and up above it was a portrait of Saint Cecilia, the patron saint of music. And years later, I figured out that was her inspiration to get through a rough lesson. She'd say, sweet Saint Cecilia, not so much to bless the lesson, but just to grant her the patience to get through another 10-year-old boy who didn't practice all week. But I must say, just a couple years later, a lot of us saw Paul McCartney play the guitar on TV, and then it all made sense. So, oh yeah, this is worth pursuing. So thank you, Sister, and sweet Saint Cecilia.
Saint Cecilia, I'm singing again. So shout alleluia and answer amen. The voice that I'm feeling is steady and strong. With laughter I poured the song. So break out the organ and break out the horn. I'll run with the thunder, I'll scream like the storm. The rivers I follow are lazy and long, and lead me right back to the song.
will last deep into the moments and years that will pass, with blessings for all good women and men. Then sweet Saint Cecilia, I'm singing again. Open the window and open the door. The sun knows the song and he's shouting for more. The darkness has fallen, the daylight will bring a time and a reason to sing. So fill up my cup with words that will last deep into the moments and years that will pass, with blessings for all good women and men. Then sweet Saint Cecilia, sweet Saint Cecilia, sweet Saint Cecilia, I'm singing again. Now for some sad and wretched blues to lift your spirits. I used to be the scariest one you ever seen, the biggest, baddest, ugliest face on Halloween. Now all my hoots and hollers are a bunch of boo-hoos, 'cause even the boogeyman has got the blues. I used to chase children through the forest preserve. I even scared the daddies when they lost the nerve. Now I'm the one who's hiding, shaking in my shoes, 'cause even the boogeyman has got the blues. But you ain't seen nothing till you seen the face of your baby getting up and walking out of the place. Don't think you're off the hook because I'm over the hill. If the boogeyman don't get you, then the blues sure will. When your crazy old granny said you better watch out, I'm the slimy stinker she was talking about. The darkest, dirty nightmare you ever had. But when you get the blues, you see I wasn't so bad, 'cause you ain't felt nothing till you feel the thump. Oh, you're girly getting goosey with some funky chump. Don't think you're off the hook because I'm over the hill. If the boogeyman don't get you, then the blues sure will. Steal kittens, bunnies, and pups. I take them to the woods and I eat them up. Now all I gotta swallow is a lot of bad news, 'cause even the boogeyman has got the blues. But you ain't hit bottom till you take the hit from your honey coming home and saying, hey, that's it. Don't think you're off the hook because I'm over the hill. If the boogeyman don't get you, then the blues sure will. Stories round the fire dragged my name into the mud. I was hiding in the bushes with a bucket of blood. Now I'm in the gutter with a bottle of booze, 'cause even the boogeyman has got the blues. Oh, the poor old boogeyman has got the blues. Even the boogeyman has got the blues. Well, it will be great when we can all get back together and do things like this in person. Of course, not just music and entertainment, the more important things, just good old hanging out, companionship. But until then, it's great to know that we can all stick together with good thoughts and warm wishes. and just the knowledge that we've got plenty of friends out there and we're still together.
Anywhere that you go, any road that you wander on your own, I'll be there in the spirit and the stone. Anywhere that you go, it's a different kind of travel. You're a different kind of rider now. A pocket full of yesterday will only slow you down. Anywhere that you go, any road that you wander on your own, I'll be there in the spirit and the stone. Anywhere that you now I can feel you burning in these empty hands of mine. Anywhere that you go, any road that you wander on your own, I'll be there in the spirit and the stone. Anywhere that you go, in my time of shining, I did not see the brightest star. Now from this distance I can see how beautiful you are. Anywhere that you go, cast it on the path you choose. I'll find it from the darkness and I'll follow it to you. Anywhere that you go, any road that you wander on your own, I'll be there in the spirit and the stone. Anywhere that you
okay, thanks for getting together and stay safe and we'll all see each other soon.